In a prior video, I made a suggestion that if you'd like to try medications for back pain, there are options including acetaminophen, which may be called paracetamol, and ibuprofen. I counseled against narcotics. Let me be clear. If you have pain, it's completely normal to want to take a medication to decrease the pain. The problem is very few people consider the risks of doing so. Everything we do medically has potential advantages, but also side effects. Let's start with acetaminophen, or in other parts of the world, it's called paracetamol. In the United States, the brand name is Tylenol. It is a commonly used drug that you can buy without prescription. I would say the vast majority of households actually has this pill in the home. Acetaminophen is a pain reliever. It's a fever reducer and can be effective for all sorts of complaints. For people with back pain or neck pain, it's often used to try to lessen the discomfort. From my standpoint, it does have its advantages. It does not need a prescription. It works well for mild to moderate pain. And in combination with activities, modifications, and stretching, it is a reasonable option. But it has associated risks. Not too long ago, doctors used to recommend that you should avoid taking more than 4 grams of acetaminophen a day. More recently, there's a movement to change that recommendation to no more than 3 grams of acetaminophen a day. Unfortunately, acetaminophen is associated with liver toxicity. In other words, it can destroy your liver. It is the number one cause of liver damage in the United States. More than 60,000 people a year go to the hospital because of acetaminophen-related overdose. Several hundred people die each year from this. In addition, if you have any other liver conditions like hepatitis, it can add to additional damage. Ibuprofen is another over-the-counter medicine that's commonly found in many homes. It too is a painkiller, but it also has anti-inflammation properties. It decreases the swelling associated with injury. Like acetaminophen, because it can be bought without prescription, many do not understand the potential side effects. Unfortunately, ibuprofen side effects include increasing your blood pressure, leading to stress on your heart and kidneys. It can cause a heart attack. It should be avoided in people who already have high blood pressure or heart disease. It can also lead to kidney failure and should be avoided by people who have any kidney issues. The other major concern is its effect on bleeding. It can thin your blood, making you more susceptible to ulcers. If a person needs to take a pill, as long as there are no significant concerns for side effects, these two medications are a reasonable option. Some may want to take aspirin. While it's also a commonly found drug, it has other side effects, including thinning of the blood, which can lead to ulcers or certain types of strokes. In addition, for children, aspirin is associated with the so-called RISE syndrome, which can cause brain and liver damage. Children should always avoid aspirin. At one time, it was a commonly taken medication to prevent heart attacks. Now it's recommended that you speak to your doctor before taking aspirin for heart attack prevention. Of the three, acetaminophen, and ibuprofen, and aspirin, aspirin is the least recommended by physicians for neck and back pain. The final discussion is about the use of narcotics. I say, don't take them for neck and back pain. It should be reserved for broken bones, post-surgical management, or in cases when you have inoperative cancer. Enough research studies have shown the use of non-narcotic pain relievers can be more effective than the narcotics. There has been too many deaths worldwide due to narcotic overdose and narcotic dependency. Also, the use of narcotics for only a week can lead to psychological dependency, altered mental state, and loss of motivation. I can't emphasize this enough. Please avoid narcotics. Nobody knows who will become addicted. Unfortunately, there are many healthcare providers, including doctors and nurses, who became dependent despite knowing the risk. To summarize, each of these medications have risks. Just because you can get some of these medications without prescription does not mean it can't cause significant harm. I'll try to avoid all medications if possible when you have neck or back pain. If you must, make sure you don't have any conditions that prevent you from taking these over-the-counter medications. Try to limit their use. I know this can be hard, especially when the pain is more severe, but you don't want to cause additional problems to your body. Thanks for watching. Our next video will be about activities changes and how your body position can impact your spine and related pains. Take care.